कृष्णा दंडवत योगा योगा एज वर्क एंड ड्यूशन वी हैव हर्ड द नेम्स ऑफ सो मेनी डिफरेंट योगज एंड योगीज बट इन भगवद गीता कृष्णा सेज दैट द एक्चुअल योगी इज ही हु हैज सरेंडर हिमसेल्फ फुल्ली अन टू मी कृष्णा प्रोक्लेम्स दैट देर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन रेनुंसिएशन संन्यासा एंड योगा What is called renunciation is the same as yoga or thinking, linking oneself with the supreme power. No one can become a yogi unless he renounces the desire for sense gratification. Bhagavad Gita 6.2 Yama sanyasam iti prahu yogam tam vidhi pandava not न रिकय असो असन्यासस्त संन्यास संकल्प योगी भवति कश्चिन इन भगवद गीता देयर आर थ्री बेसिक टाइप्स ऑफ योगा डेलिनेटेड कर्म योगा ज्ञान योगा एंड भक्ति योगा द सिस्टम ऑफ योगा मे बी लाइकन्ड टू अ स्टेयरकेस Someone may be on the first step, someone may be halfway up, and someone may be on the top step. When one is elevated to certain levels, he is known as Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, etc. In all cases, the service to the Supreme Land, Supreme Lord is the same. It is a difference in elevation only. Thus, Sri Krishna tells Arjuna that he must understand that renunciation, sannyasa, and yoga are the same. Because without being freed from desire and sense gratification, one can become neither a yogi nor a sannyasi.
There are some yogis who perform yoga for a profit, but that is not real yoga. Everything must be engaged in the service of the Lord. Whatever we do as an ordinary worker or a sannyasi or as a yogi or as a philosopher must be done in Krishna consciousness. When we are absorbed in the thought of serving Krishna and when we act in the consciousness, we can become real sannyasi and real yogis. For those who are taking the first step up the staircase of the yoga system, there is work. One should not think that simply because he is beginning yoga, he should stop working. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna asks Arjuna to become a yogi, but he never tells him to cease from fighting. Quite the contrary. Of course, now one may ask how a person may be a yogi and at that same time a warrior. Our conception of yoga practice is that of sitting very straight with legs crossed and eyes half closed, staring at the tip of our nose and concentrating in this way in a lonely place. So how is it that Krishna is asking Arjuna to become a yogi and at the same time participate in the ghastly civil war? That is the mystery of Bhagavad Gita. One can remain a fighting man at the same time be the highest yogi, the highest sannyasi. How is this possible? In Krishna consciousness, one simply has to fight for Krishna, work for Krishna, eat for Krishna, sleep for Krishna, dedicate all activities to Krishna. In this way, one becomes the highest yogi and the highest sannyasi. That is the secret. In the sixth chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna instructs Arjuna how to perform meditational yoga, but Arjuna rejects this as too difficult. How then is Arjuna considered to be a great yogi? Although Krishna saw that Arjuna was rejecting the meditational system, he proclaimed Arjuna to be the highest yogi because you are always thinking of me. Thinking of Krishna is the essence of all yoga systems. Of the Hatha, Karma, Jnana, Bhakti or any other system of yoga, sacrifice or charity. All the recommended activities for spiritual realization end in Krishna consciousness in thinking always of Krishna. The actual perfection of human life lies in being always Krishna conscious and always being aware of Krishna while performing all types of activities. In the preliminary stage, One is advised to always work for Krishna. One must be always searching out some duty or some engagement, for it is a bad policy to remain idle even for a second. When one actually becomes advanced through such engagements, then he may not work physically, but he is always engaged within by constantly thinking of Krishna. In the preliminary stage, however, one is always advised to engage one's senses in the service of Krishna. There are a variety of activities one can perform in serving Krishna. The International Society for Krishna Consciousness is intended to help direct aspirant devotees in these ways. Activities for those working in Krishna consciousness, there are simply not enough hours in the day to serve Krishna. There are always activities, engagements both day and night, which the student of Krishna consciousness performs joyfully. That is the stage of real happiness, constant engagement for Krishna and spreading Krishna consciousness around the world. In the material world, one may become very tired if he works all the time. But if one works in Krishna consciousness, he can chant Hare Krishna and engage in devotional service 24 hours a day and never get tired. But if we vibrate some mundane vibrations, then we soon become exhausted. There is no question of becoming tired on the spiritual platform. The spiritual platform is absolute. In the material world, everyone is working for sense gratification. The profits of one's labor in the material world are used to gratify one's senses. But a real yogi does not desire such fruits. He has no desire other than Krishna, and Krishna is already there.